Hey guys, this is Electro16. Today I'm going to show you the Marvel Legends Spider-Man Rhino Wave. First off, here we have White Tiger. Very nice figure. Not a character that I'm all that familiar with. I learned about the character through the Ultimate Spider-Man TV show. So, very nice figure, very nice sculpt, like the paint job, the green eyes and her green and yellow necklace. basically a, some would say a plain figure, because it's mostly just white, with the gray accents, but I think it's very nice with the like I said, with the accents and the green eyes, and looks very nice. And she comes with Rhino's torso. Next we have Misty Knight. Another character that I'm not all that familiar with. Although it is a nice figure. Very nicely sculpted. Very nice paint job. All the straps and the buckles on her costume, and her mechanical arm there, right arm. And face is very nice. And she also comes with Rhino's torso, since she is the variant to White Tiger. Next we have Ghost Rider. Very nice figure. Very nicely sculpted. Very nice paint job. I think one of the nicest Ghost Rider sculpts we've had so far. The head looks absolutely amazing. What it's sculpted and the translucent fire on his head there, and on his neck, very nice. Has a chain around his torso, and I know that his jaw is articulated, and he comes with Rhino's left leg. Next we have Superior Venom. another character that I'm not all that familiar with. I don't really read comics anymore. So what I do know is from basically seeing stuff online and cartoons on TV. But so this, I know this is like the same gimmick as they did it with Spider-Man, which basically is Doc Ock taking over, Doc Ock's consciousness taking over this body. He's probably my least favorite figure in this wave. The paint job is alright. I think that it, these one-shot characters that you don't see all that, you know, all that long in the comics, they should skip them. I mean, they don't bring anything. I know some people want them, but I mean, you know, basically the one-shot. I mean, you see them once and then you don't see them again. So I think it's kind of a waste of a slot in the wave to use these one-shots. And he comes with Rhino's right arm. Next we have Chameleon. I've been waiting for so long and hoping for so long for a Chameleon figure. I was really excited when I heard that they were finally getting one. Looks really, really, really amazing. Very nice figure, very nice sculpt. I love the paint job. He comes with two alternate heads, Hammerhead and J. Jonah Jameson. He comes with three guns. got a little sort of pistol here, a machine gun, and some other, I don't know what that's supposed to be, some kind of imitation, old style, but with a modern twist, sort of machine gun. And he comes with Rhino's left arm. Next we have Kraven, another amazing looking figure. He's in top three of this wave, as far as I'm concerned. An amazing looking figure. The sculpt is incredible. The paint job is incredible. From, you know, when you see all the details of his necklace, his sort of lion jacket there. His belt, all the pouches, the buckle, the skull, the knee pads, even the details on his staff here look amazing. The feathers and sort of like this red little necklace. Really, really top notch figure. And he comes with Rhino's, I believe it's his right leg. And finally, we have Scarlet Spider, another very nice figure, very nice sculpt, very nice paint job, also a very nice update to the previous Scarlet Spider we had from the original one we had from Toy Biz. He just come with four extra hands. One whipping hand, two climbing hands, and one fisted hand. And he does come with Rhino's two heads. And so here, this is the original Toy Biz Scarlet Spider. And here, this is a custom that I have. I did not make this custom. I bought it at a store. The owner had purchased a Marvel Legends collection, and that happened to be in there. And I didn't have this one here at the time, so he filled the spot until I got this one. But I just had to keep it on the list because I thought it was really nice. And I have no idea what base figure it's from. I'm assuming it's a Spider-Man, because you see here he has like a whipping hand. I have no idea what these are from, but that was really nice. So so guys, that's it for this time. Don't forget to hit the like button, comment, and subscribe, and until next time.